In this illustration, we'll be studying about a case when potassium is collecting some energy. Here we are given that a potassium surface is placed 75 cm away from a 100 watt bulb. It is found that the energy radiated by bulb is 5% of the input power. That means out of 100 watt, it is only radiating 5 watt energy. And we need to consider each potassium atom as a circular disc of diameter 1 angstrom. Then we are required to determine the time required for each atom to absorb an amount of energy equal to its work function 2 electron volt. And also we are required to find the time if we consider atom to be spherical. Now in solution here we can see, if we talk about a bulb which is located at a point which is radiating energy in all directions and it is of 100 watt power. And from the bulb at a distance r is equals to 75 cm, we are having a surface which is potassium, and a potassium atom we consider of diameter d is equals to 1 angstrom, which is placed in front of it. So if power of bulb is p, then we can directly calculate the light intensity at surface on its center is, here we are talking about the center point of the surface in front of the bulb, then this intensity we can give as p by 4 pi r square. This is given in watt per meter square. Now if we talk about the power received by each atom on surface at center is PR, then we can write the value of this received power is equals to this intensity multiplied by pi d square by 4, as d is the diameter of the disc where we are assuming the potassium atom as a circular disc. So this is the power which it is receiving. So in this situation we can easily calculate here, this intensity will be p by 4 pi r square. So power can be taken as 100 multiplied by 5 by 100, as only 5% of the input power is radiated, multiply by 1 by 4 pi r square. So this 1 upon 4 pi, this 0.75 square, multiplied by pi d square by 4. So in this situation d is 1 angstrom, so this will be 10 to power minus 10 whole square divided by 4. Here pi gets cancelled out and this 100 also gets cancelled out. And on simplifying here, if this is the power received, then we can directly write, if in time t atom, we are talking about potassium atom, receives energy equal to 2 electron volt, which is the work function of it. Here we use this power received multiplied by time is equals to 2 electron volt is 2 multiplied by 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19. So if we continue here, we can write the value of time we are getting is this 2 multiplied by 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 divided by the radiated power which is being received by the atom. So this can be further written as 2 into 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 multiplied by 4 into 0.75 whole square divided by, here it is 5 multiplied by, this 4 can be taken as 0.5 into 10 to power minus 10 whole square. On simplifying, we are getting the value of time as 57.6 seconds. That is the result of this problem. Here we are also required to see what will be the time if we consider atom to be spherical. Here we can see if atom is considered as a disk, then also it subtends the same solid angle if it is considered as a sphere, because the diameter of this atom is very small compared to R. So here we can write as D is very, very less than R. No change in time will be there as energy received by atom remains same even if it is considered as a sphere. So be careful about it. Whenever required for a small sized, the projected area of a sphere is same as that of disk, so it won't change.